Hello students, let's start with next part of unit 4, that is windowing and clipping. Now before starting, let's revise some terms. We are familiar with the term window. A window, obviously we are familiar with it. It is nothing but we can imagine just a rectangular portion through which we can see any image or a scene basically. It is an opening through which we can see a portion of the world that exists outside. Normally, when we are looking from the window, some portion of the scene is visible to us. That is anything you can imagine. It may be building, some tree, roads, etc. But we have the limitation of the scene specified by the boundary of the window. So, the scene gets cut off by the boundary of the window and we can only see a part of the scene, right? Now, it does not mean that whatever we have seen, that part only exists and the other does not. The other part also exists, but we are not able to see that. It means we are limiting our view with an artificial device called as window. The idea of window is actually very important in computer graphics. Suppose some complex drawing or maps are drawn on computer. Say road map of Maharashtra state, and we want to read the road map for particularly Pune city, then it will be very difficult to read the map. So in that case, it will be useful to display only that part of the drawing in which we are interested. So this gives the effect of looking at the image through window. That means we are limiting our scope. Similarly, if we want to see the roadmap of Nashik city, then we have to concentrate on the part of map. So by changing the position of window, we can select other portion of the drawing for visualization. The method of selecting and enlarging the portion of the drawing is called windowing. Let me repeat, the method of selecting and enlarging the portion of a drawing, it's called windowing. Now we cannot limit what we want to see on computer screen just by drawing window frame. Instead, we must not draw that part of total picture which we want to suppress. Now we all know about the photographer's camera, right? When we look through the camera towards some scene, we are able to see the scene, but in addition to that scene, we see a rectangular area also. The final photograph gets developed with the scene which is inside that rectangular area. Now, it does not mean that we should not see the things which is outside the rectangle area. So, in other words, we are not drawing the portion of the scene which is outside the rectangular area. Determining which portion to omit or suppress is called clipping. Understood? Determining which portion to omit or suppress is called clipping. Clipping eliminates the object or portion of the object which are not visible through the window. Right? Did you get the point? So what is window and what is clipping? Window is method of selecting and enlarging the portion of drawing. A particular portion is called as windowing. And the portion which is to be omitted or suppressed is called as clipping. Here some images are given. So suppose this is a window and these are the images. So the portion which is outside the image, here we have enlarged the image. Here we have zoom out of the image. And then next, here we can see we have enlarged particular this portion of the image. So when this portion is windowed, we can see through the window, the other portion which is outside the window is omitted. That is, it is clipped. We can see in the fourth image. So this is windowing and clipping. Now what is viewport? Viewport or viewing transformation comes under viewing transformation. Now whenever we want to display any scene, we are actually considering two models of that scene. They are object model and image model. When we are saying object, we are referring a model of the object which is stored in computer with the actual size. It may be millimeter or in kilometer. The space where object model reside is called as object space. Image model is one which appear on display device. The image which we want to draw on display device must be measured in screen coordinates. Now there are different types of display device with variations of screen coordinates. So to make a screen coordinate device independent, we have to use normalized coordinates. We must convert the object space into the image space coordinate. Now for this, we have to use scaling transformation. We all know about scaling transformation, right? Scaling is done to change the size of the image. Do you remember? Size of the image. Now then, before proceeding to transformation, we will first see another term which is called as viewport. Now what is viewport? It may happen that we may not want to use entire screen for display, and we just want some part of the screen to display the image. So we will form a rectangular box on screen, and in that box only we will display the image. This box is called as viewport. Did you get the point? I'll repeat. Now suppose we do not want an entire screen for displaying anything. So in that case, and we want just some part of the screen to display the image. So in that case, we'll form a rectangular box on the screen, and in that box only will display the image. So this box which we have created is called as viewport. Did you get the terms object model and image model? Object model is the actual model with actual size and actual scale, and image model is the model with approximate image coordinates or display screen coordinates, right? Now the object space contains the dimensions as actual, right? Object model is placed on object space. The object space contain the dimensions as actual, which is called as world coordinate system, right? All the objects which we see in the world defines the world coordinate system. Now let us revise all the three terms once again. We can say a world coordinate area, the world coordinate area selected for display. Did you get the point? The world coordinate area selected for display is called window. Then an particular area on a display device to which a window is mapped is called viewport. So the window defines what is to be viewed, and clipping means what to omit. Get the point? Clipping means what is to be omitted, and viewport defines where it is to be displayed on the device. Understood? Now what is window? An area on display device to which a particular area, or we can say in simple terms, now we know world coordinate system, so we'll say a world coordinate area selected for displaying is called window. Then we can say that any area on display device to which a window is mapped is called viewport. And clipping means what is to be omitted. And viewport defines where it is to be displayed on the display device. Okay. Now what is viewing transformation? Now see, if we are changing the position of window by keeping the viewport location constant, then the different part of the object is displayed at the same portion on the display device. Right? Similarly, if we want to change the location of viewport, then we'll see the same part of object drawn at different places on the screen. In general, the mapping of the of a part of the world coordinate scene to device coordinates is referred as viewing transformation. Sometimes it is also called as window view transformation or windowing transformation. Actually, basically, this viewing transformation is process of three steps. Three steps which define translation, scaling, and retranslation. We know all the three terms: translation, scaling, and retranslation. What is translation? Translation is, yes, do you remember? Translation, we have seen this in transformations, 2D transformation, 3D transformation. Translation is nothing but dragging the object or changing the place of object in any specific direction. And scaling is changing size of the object. Then retranslation, placing the object again on its original position. See, you can see this image here. These are the world coordinate system. So this is your actual image with actual scaling, right? Now here is the window. According to this window, this portion is only to be viewed. Okay, window shows the portion to be viewed. So in the next image, we can see only the portion to be viewed and the window is placed. So this is called as viewpoint. These are world coordinates, device coordinates. We have seen what is clipping. Clipping means omitting the part of the picture, right? Next, we'll start with line clipping. We will see line clipping in next video.